Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to my product reviews. Now, if you're into product photography, you're probably well aware that you sometimes get dust on your product and that takes a lot of cleaning out in post-production, especially if you want to be very particular and don't want to have dust on your shots. Now, you might resort to something like a soft brush to brush away the surface dust that you can see. You might resort to something like one of these canned airs. These are fine for this type of product where you've not got electronic equipment or lenses. You can aim this at the product, but if you notice, there is sometimes propellant which comes out of the can, especially if you're shaking it. And especially if you invert it, you get a real blast of propellant. Now that would be no good on a lens. It would get inside the lens element, could cause staining and other problems. So better to use this on products that you're not particular with. Not recommended in real terms to use the air dusters in a can. The soft brush does tend to remove quite a lot of the dust, especially when this becomes statically charged. It does take off the dust and you can go over your product just before you do the product shoot and probably in between shots to make sure that you're not gathering dust as the dust settles on your shot. But what I've been sent by EM Great is this product for you to have a look at. And it's the BlowerBaby from a company called Nitecore. Now, Nitecore do a lot of camera accessories, especially in the lithium ion charging business. So this is a departure for them into this market. So the BlowerBaby is a device which is self-contained. It's got its own inbuilt lithium ion power source and a high-speed fan, which blows air out of a nozzle at up to speeds of 45 miles an hour with the supplied filter. There is a micro mesh filter, which is used if you want to use this device to clean the center of your camera. It's a much finer filter, which filters out the air particles that might be blasted through the fan at high speed toward your sensor. So it's a much finer filter. They also supply with this kit the camera cleaning pen, which is a cleaning pen, which is used in conjunction with the blower accessory. It's got a carbon tip, so you can use that to remove fingerprints from your lenses after you've used the soft brush to remove any dust particles from that lens surface. And I'll show you how these work. So let's have a closer look at the BlowerBaby and let's see how it works. So this is a product. Neat product, very nice packaging. High gloss and matte finish. It's a nice presentation. Check out the box. And again, you can probably see there we've got a matte finish box with some glossy print on there. It looks very, very professional. Let's remove it from the box. And you can see in there a little card that says, "Begin your new era of electronic air blowing." So remove that card. And we've got the device here in the box. And you can see we've got the device and included with it is the charging cable, which is USB-A to USB-C, as this is a USB-C charge device. Inbuilt lithium ion battery, 1500 milliamp hours, gives you a sufficient runtime for 90 cleans at roughly 10 seconds per clean. So let's get this device out. But what I've noticed is the on-off switch is directly in one of the cutouts that you put your finger or thumb in to remove it. So it's better to keep your finger towards the front, well away from the power on-off button. Otherwise, when you put your fingers and thumb in there, you sometimes turn on the device as you're taking it out. So it's better to keep your finger towards the front of the assembly and lift it out. It's quite stiff in the packaging. And again, inadvertently touching that power on-off button to get this device out. A little bit bigger slots might be in order to allow larger finger and thumb if the Nitecore want to do some product changes. So this is the device. It's all metal and the tip is a soft plastic, so it doesn't scratch your lens if you actually touch the surface with it. Self-contained lithium ion battery, 1500 milliamp hours, 22.2 watts. Again, charged by that USB-C charging port, which you can see on the base of the unit here. This is a power on off button and the power indicator. Blue when you're fully charged and it's red flashing when it's discharged. The power on off button, a single press and hold will keep the blower unit running while you've got your finger on the button, and a double press will keep it on continuous. So let me just press it to show you. So that is the instantaneous, if you like, while your finger's on the button. Double press that button. And a single press to stop it. So the business end is this nozzle, roughly 1.5 centimeters by 1 centimeter. And here is the input filter mesh. We can remove that. And you can see just inside there, we have a centrifugal fan that's driven to drive the air through the device. You might just be able to see in there, there is a fine mesh filter behind that port there. There is a arrow on the lid here, which aligns with an arrow on there to show you where to orientate that when you reinstall it. The supplied accessory, which is a smaller mesh filter, is used if you're going to be cleaning the sensor of your camera, and I'll show you that shortly. But this is a much finer filter. Get it out of its case. Again, behind that mesh is a much finer nylon mesh to reduce the size of particles that are being blown in through the unit. By the fact that it's a finer mesh, it also reduces the airflow through the device. So instead of the airflow coming out about up to 45 miles an hour, it's reduced to about 31 miles an hour. So we'll go back to the original filter for a moment. And install the original filter. In the lens cleaning kit, try and open it without ripping the tab, which I normally do with these boxes. The instructions of how to use the device. You can see again it's attractively packaged in this yellow box, again with two finger holes to remove the device. But again, I suggest they make these notches a little bit bigger to enable larger fingers and thumbs to get in there. This is quite a slippy product, and I found it difficult to get out the first time that I used it. So it's still quite difficult to remove, but say with a bigger finger and thumb you probably struggle to get in there. So a little bit of redesign on there to allow bigger notches would be in order. So this is the lens cleaning pen, and in the handle of it you've got two brushes. We've got a stiff bristle brush for cleaning the camera bodies, and we've got a very soft brush for cleaning the camera lens. And again, they are magnets in here and a magnetic material in the base of the unit, so you can store them neatly for use afterwards. The actual pen itself again is magnetically connected. You twist that around to apply some carbon to the tip, turn it out, install it the other way around, and now you've got a cleaning surface. And if I just get a lens out here, so this is a Canon 50mm f1.4. So if you noticed any dust on there, you could actually, before you use the carbon pen, use the soft nylon brush, install that on the device like so, and then you could actually use this to blow off the dust from the surface of the lens. Again, just press and hold the button. And that removes any surplus dust, and then you can use the lens pen with its carbon impregnation. As usual, you do a circular scrolling motion around the surface of the lens, reducing in diameter until you get it in the center, and that will remove fingerprints from the lens surface, and you get a very, very clean lens surface. I use lens pens virtually every time I take the lens out. If you are cleaning the camera body, then you could use the harder bristle brush, or if you're cleaning product, again you could use the harder bristle brush on the product with the blower to remove material. So let's just change from the soft brush to the hard brush like so, and then you'd use it again by just holding the button down and brushing across your product. Like so, and that removes all that surface dust and you should get much cleaner images. So that removes the surface dust and you should get much cleaner images and spend less time touching up your images to get rid of those dust spots. Now the accessory that's available as a separate accessory is for cleaning the sensor, and I'll attempt to clean the sensor of my Canon 5D Classic. So we'll install first of all the micro mesh filter on the blower to reduce the amount of size of particles that are being sucked in by the fan and blown out, and it also reduces the airflow as I've mentioned previously. So let me just install this onto the blower, again aligning the arrow with the arrow on the body. Just rotate that to lock it in place. Put these out of the way and we'll get the 5D Classic out. I'll turn it on and put it into the sensor cleaning mode. Scroll all the way down, sensor cleaning. And that opens up the mirror. So the mirror is now flipped up. And if I can just catch some light in there. You can see in the back of the camera is the sensor there, and that is the surface that we're going to remove the dust from. Now I know the sensor is clean because I've just used the camera, so there are no dust spots on the camera, but you would use it in such a manner that you would blow the air from this device onto the sensor. So again, holding the camera vertical so any dust will fall out, and again by just pressing and holding the button you'll direct the air from that nozzle into the camera and try and remove the dust from the sensor. And replace the body cap and turn off the camera to return the mirror down. You could actually do the same process for the mirror. If you've got dust on the mirror, you could then just blow the dust off the mirror and off the focus screen. Then replace your body cap or lens to stop any more ingress of dust. In my opinion, that's a much better way of cleaning the sensor than using these wet sensor cleaning kits. Obviously, if you're unfortunate to get a fingerprint on your sensor, this is really the only way you can remove that fingerprint, or splashes from salt water or something like that, if you've been unlucky to get the salt water splash inside the camera. Particularly if you're using mirrorless with the sensor very close to the surface, especially the like the Canon EOS M range where the flange back distance is very small, the sensor is almost at the front face of the camera, so chances of getting fingerprints and dust on there are quite high, so you might have to resort to a liquid lens cleaning solution rather than a blower if you're unfortunate enough to get splashes or fingerprints on your sensor. But for general cleaning where you've seen dust spots in the sky, this would be an ideal application of this device to blow that dust off the sensor without actually running the risk of damaging it by using the wet wand principles. So there we are, that's the Nitecore BlowerBaby. I'll put links to its source on the Amazon site. You'll be able to see the availability and the current price in your particular country. So that's it for this review. Hope you found that useful. If you like my styles of review and not seen them before, why not click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I upload new videos to the channel. Also check out my photographic blog. You'll find lots of information on Panasonic newish bridge cameras if you're into bridge cameras, and also on the Canon EOS M mirrorless series of cameras. So until my next video, as usual, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very shortly.